Hey, what's up? Welcome to a new quick edit video. And today I want to work on this mountainscape and turn it into a nice black and white image with a subtle blue color cast. For the editing, I will be using Adobe Photoshop and maybe make use of the Nick Collection plugin, but I'm not sure about that at this point. So before I start, let's first take a look at the before and after images. Alright, and as you can see, I'm in the Camera Raw Editor, that's the Raw Editor of Photoshop. Now, first I want to head to the Lens Correction tab, activate those two settings, and then just go back to the Basic tab. As I just said, I want to turn this into a black and white image, so instead of the color treatment, I'm choosing black and white. Now you might think the white balance doesn't have an influence on a black and white image, but for this shot I want to turn the temperature all the way up. And you can see this will just boost the highlights in a nice way. Alright, then according to the histogram, we do have a lot of room to the left and to the right. So first let me increase the exposure slightly. And I think I can add some contrast straight away. For some extra sharpness, I'm adding a little bit of texture. For more detail, I'm adding some clarity. Also, I want to add some overall negative dehaze, which will just make the image a little brighter again. Also, this will help to add some hazy look to the image, which works pretty good in this case. So then it's time for the local adjustments. First, I want to darken the sky, mainly the blue part of it. And for this, I have applied this gradiated filter, which basically covers this area. And since I only want to target the blue of the sky, and this is of course the darkest part of the sky, I can simply select a luminance range mask. And by setting a range like this, I'm telling this gradiated filter to only target the darker colors of the image. So in this case, the blue sky in the back. Now, if I want to darken it, I could simply drop the exposure and you see the clouds aren't affected by it. In this case, I simply want to drop the whites all the way down. And that's it for this gradiated filter. Then you can see I have applied another gradiated filter for the foreground and I just want to make this a little brighter, so let's increase the exposure again. And I also want to increase this foggy look down there, so let's again decrease the dehaze. Also, I can make everything look a bit softer by dropping the texture and the clarity. Okay, then that's it for this filter. Then let's head to the radial filters. Here I have applied one for the mountain range. That's because I want to add more detail to this mountain range, and for this I'm simply increasing the clarity. And that's it for the local adjustments. Then let's go into the detail tab to sharpen the image real quick. And also for this image, I want to go use the split toning. That's because, as I said in the intro, I want to have a subtle blue color cast. And here I'm simply adding a blue hue to the shadows. And let's boost the saturation. And this looks so much better in my opinion. Okay, nice. Finally, I want to apply some vignetting, which can be found in the Effects tab, down there. And that's basically it for the raw adjustments. Now let's open up the image. The very first thing I want to do is to crop it a little bit, since the right side doesn't look as interesting as the left side. So I'm hitting the C button. And I'm holding down shift to keep the ratio. And let's make it a little smaller here. I think that's much better. And it seems there's a weird sensor spot up there. So I'm grabbing the spot healing brush and just paint over it. Okay. Alright, then let's see. Maybe I can apply some Nick Collection effects. Therefore, I'm heading to the plugin right there. Now, for this shot, I want to go with the polarization effect. Turn up the strength a little bit, which will make the sky a little darker. I don't want to go overboard with this, so let's keep it at those levels. Okay. Also, I might want to get rid of this little cloud part right there. So let's try the spot healing brush again. Perfect. At this point, I want to stop the editing because I think this looks already pretty awesome. So I hope this was an interesting and helpful quick edit video. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments, and thank you very much for watching this video.